Hey everyone, I'm Rob Franek. I'm Editor-in-Chief here at the Princeton Review, and I'm back with you again today to talk about three very important exams, the GRE, the GMAT, and the LSAT. And we're going to start off talking about the graduate record examinations. Now that's, of course, the GRE. And we're going to start there because it is truly the most versatile of the three exams that we'll be talking about today. While the GRE is required for graduate school admission programs, it is not exclusively for graduate school admission. It is also accepted by a number of business schools in lieu of the GMAT, and of course a number of law schools in lieu of the LSAT. And it's also worth noting that the reverse is not typically true. If you're applying to a PhD program in history, then you're probably going to sit for the GRE, while the GMAT and the LSAT will simply not do for those grad school programs, again, unless you're applying to business school or law schools directly. Now, due to test center closings, the GRE has been offered as a remote online exam since late March of 2020. If you haven't seen it already, take a look at our video about what your at-home GRE testing experience will actually be like. Now, initially, the testing requirements for the GRE at home were very stringent, including being limited to PCs only, but I'm pleased to report, my friends, that the at-home GRE is now available for Mac users as well. Now, in addition, the folks at ETS, now those are the creators of the GRE, are extending the at-home testing until September 30th of 2020, and they'll continue to evaluate the situation in case a further extension is needed. But we are starting to see reopenings. GRE testing centers in some areas have opened already with, of course, enhanced precautions. Now, depending on where you live, it seems that you may actually have a choice about your preferred testing environment. Now, let's switch to the next exam. If you're going to be a future MBA candidate, then you probably already know that the GMAT has also gone online and at home. Now, we devoted a specific video to the GMAT online and that testing experience and what you can expect on this YouTube channel, so you can certainly check out the video. But I bring it up to you today because there's a very welcome update. That is that the GMAT online test takers will now have the option to use a physical and not just a digital whiteboard. And any test taker who took the GMAT online prior to June 11th can register to retake the GMAT online with the use of a physical whiteboard. Unfortunately, you're still going to have to pay the additional $200 testing fee, but you would be able to take the GMAT online exam a second time, and your better score will, of course, be the one that actually gets reported. Now, the GMAT online will be available until July 17th, though again, that may get extended as needed. As with the GRE, test centers in some areas have already reopened, of course, with enhanced precautions. Now, the GMAC, now that's the Graduate Management Admission Council, that's the testing team that creates the GMAT, they've said that you can choose your test format, either online or in person, if test centers are open in your area. Now, moving on to our last promised exam, the LSAT. Rather, the lsat-flex. Now, that's the at-home version of the LSAT that came about because of COVID-19 related test center closures. Now, as with the GRE and the GMAT, we created a standalone video specifically about the lsat-flex and the testing experience that you'll likely have. Now, the first lsat-flex administration took place between May 18th and May 22nd. Now, LSAC, which is the Law School Admission Council, who creates all things LSAT, reports that while some students did experience some technical difficulties, 99% of the nearly 10,000 test takers who started the test successfully were able to complete it. Now, LSAC has also said that they'll use the experience of delivering the May LSAT Flex exam to improve future LSAT Flex administration. Now, speaking specifically about future LSAT Flex administrations, the next set of administration that will take place is coming up, and that is beginning June 14th. The July LSAT Flex will begin during the week of July 12th. Now, at present, the LSAC has not made a determination about whether the LSAT Flex will be given in August. But of course, we'll be monitoring that information and we'll keep you posted as that information becomes available. Now, friends, if you've taken one of these exams, the GRE, the GMAT, or the LSAT at home, then leave us a comment and tell us how it went for you. Please don't share your experience with the test content. Just give us your guidance as to whether you found the experience to be smooth and how it compared to previous test center experiences that you've had. And as always, I'll be back reporting this information to you as it becomes available. If you haven't already, please do subscribe to our channel for the latest updates. And of course, best of luck with your prep. We know you're going to be awesome at this.